okay, y'all. So here we go. Project number two. Yesterday I taught y'all how to draw circles and make them look 3D. And so I got to thinking about those circles being 3D. And oh, by the way, I'm a little festive. I got my Hawaiian shirt on. And I've got my head lit up because it's gonna be spring. And I put my jewelry on, some of it, because I felt weird without it yesterday. So we're gonna go with a little more color. And I'm going to show you a process that is pretty cool. You can use it for a lot of different things. Matter of fact, I painted a ceiling like this at one point. Ready? Drum roll. Bam! Yeah, get it up closer. Y'all can see it better. Mm-hmm. It's just a little planetary design, picture, whatever. Okay? So there's some things that you need for this, and yesterday, plain paper. Y'all got some plain paper. You can use notebook paper. Those crazy lines are going to show up, but whatever. Okay. So you need plain paper. You need scissors. Tape. I use masking tape, but y'all can use scotch tape or whatever. Duct tape, but you don't really want to stick. Pencil. Yeah. Bowl. I found my bowl. Some little things to draw around, which we'll talk about in a minute. And the pièce de resistance. Mustard. That's my shirt. Mustard. And toothpaste. And your mom's gonna love this, right? And old. I repeat, old. And not your brother's. Could be your brother's, but let's keep that between us. Old toothbrush. Don't be using your own because it took me a long time to get the mustard out of my toothbrush earlier. So, here's what y'all want to do. Okay? Now, first thing we're going to do is we're going to take that picture. We're going to take those crayons and we're just going to randomly put them all over the page. Now, I did take pictures of this in steps, but because I'm so tech challenged, I'm like going through my printer ink like crazy. So, I did take a picture of it. There we go. This is just this with crayon, sorry, marker all over it. Okay? And I skipped that part, so let's go back. For this project, you can use colored pencils, markers, or crayons. You could also use paint. But I'm assuming that a lot of y'all don't have paint, so, and if you have markers laying around. Now, if you decide to use crayons, you have to stick to crayons. You cannot mix these markers with the crayons because the markers do not like the crayon and the crayon do not like the marker because the crayon is what? Waxy. And the markers are not waxy. So they get together and they resist each other. Okay? Now I used a bunch of markers because I got a bunch of them I needed to go through. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is take a piece of paper. You can use a full piece of paper. I used just a half because I was, kind of in a hurry. And you just take your marker. Now, remember yesterday when I was talking to you all about going in little circles and all that? Okay, for markers, unless you're getting into Copic markers, however you want to say, we're going to talk about that down the road. They're very expensive, like 10 bucks a piece. We ain't got them. We got regular old time markers. Go ahead and keep the direction of your coloring in the same line. And you do want to kind of go ahead in some spots and let that overlap. Now, here's another. I'm going to give you lots of rules, okay? Not rules, but like rules to make things successful. One of the rules of design is when you use a color in one area, you want to use that color in several areas. Your eyes want to make sense of things. Your eyes like to connect things. Your eyes are looking for patterns. And when your eyes don't find a pattern, it kind of throws things off and creates an unwanted focal point. You don't have to worry about that now. Okay, so once you get your entire page covered with crayon or colored pencil, and colored pencil really works the best because you can shade it and kind of blend it in, then you set that aside. Okay, now you're going to go run around And you know, yesterday when I told y'all not to use like lids and things like that to draw around, well, you need to go find them today. And so you need small objects. Here's a coaster that a really nice lady that retired gave to me. And someday I might be able to retire, but I doubt it. And then here's like a lid and a lid I found on the floor. I don't know what that went to. And then quarter. If y'all go swiping the quarters, you better be giving them back or at least ask for it first. Okay. Different size circles. Now, you need a separate piece of paper. I got some construction paper, but it does not have to be construction paper. Okay. So, you're going to lay that down. And you're just going to trace around your circle. Okay. Simple. Easy peasy, right? All right. Let me just show you all. Just about lost that quarter. Okay. And my big old circle right here. All right, now, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to cut these. Can y'all see them? You're going to want to cut those out. Okay? Now, let's talk about cutting for a minute. I have seen every type of cutting in the entire, I've seen every angle of cutting. Sometimes I think it'd be easier if kids use their feet. So, the first thing you want to do, if you want to cut this area right here, is cut a fat hog and get that corner. Get the rest of this paper you do not need out of the way. Yeah. Okay, while we're on the subject, let me give you a real quick cutting lesson. When you cut, this is the movement. The hand that has the scissors, up and down, up and down, up and down. This one. Is all the moving. Where was I? Okay, so y'all, you're cutting a circle, you're cutting a circle, and all of a sudden now you're like, no, bite, turn, bite, turn, simple, I know, okay. So now I need to cut some of these. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come apart, and I need several of each one, so maybe four or five, whatever. So if you can manage it, I'm going to cut another fat hog. And here I got my circle. See it? And I'm going to cut about three or four random pieces of paper that are a little bit bigger than that circle. I'm going to layer them all together like this. Now, at this point, you can staple those together if you feel like you can't hold on to them. Or if it's easier for you just to cut one at a time, that's fine. Me, myself, I ain't got time. I got to cut me a fat hog. And you just start to cut. Now, y'all, look. What am I doing? Am I moving my elbow? No, I am not moving my elbow. What am I I'm moving this arm. I'm going around and around. And around, and around, 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 just like that. Okay? All right. So let's pretend I've got all of my different size circles. All right? And I've got my paper. I'm just going to pretend. Okay? Get all this crap out of the way. Now, I take my... Here, let me just show you real quick. This would just be easier. Just bear with me real quick. Here, hold just a moment. I'll color some and I'll be right back. Okay, so now I got my paper colored. Now, I'm going to take my circles. Now, my circles have black on them, and I'll show you why in a minute. Then I want to cut more. Okay, so I've got my circles, and I'm just going to place them randomly on. And I'm going to put tape on the back, and I'm just going to place them randomly on my drawing, just wherever. Okay, here's another. The rules, the rules. You suck with the rules. Okay, but anyway, another rule is on almost all artwork or all designs or all paintings or basically designs, a rule of thumb is if an object goes off on one side, it needs to go off on all sides. Okay. So right here you got, right here, like take for instance, you got little Mr. Planet out here. He's going off. He's going, you know, see, I have that circle right there. That's creating a border over here that is not part of the design. So when you look at it, or the viewer looks at it, they're gonna be like, oh, there ain't nothing going on over there. I'm gonna be looking over this way. Mm-mm. You want the viewer to look at the entire design. So I'm gonna put this guy. Okay, so now we go off here, and we go off here, and pretty close going off here, and then where's your border? Where's your border? Where's your border? So I don't know where that big old circle is. I guess it's on the floor or something. I don't know. I don't need it. Oh, we'll need it right there. Okay? And you just keep playing around. Like I added more. Okay? Now, when y'all get those circles on there, what you're going to do is lay it down. And then, hold on. I'm going to flip this around so you can see what I'm doing. Okay? Okay, I was going to wait to get something taller, but I can't wait because I want y'all to hear this song because it's Sonny and Cher, don't you know? Honey. All right, take your marker, black marker, and just go around the edge of that circle. Give yourself a nice little border. Try not to go under. If y'all go underneath, you're going to mess that circle up. Look, see? If you happen to go underneath, what can you do? Make it a smaller circle, y'all. Can you see over here? Go share. All right. And color it in. If you're really good, like me, because I'm really good, you can just lay that circle down. Go all around it. Now, I would strongly suggest you draw a line around it, because I was going like this earlier without a border, and then I was getting underneath of it. Cover the entire area with that black marker. Whole thing. But y'all gotta leave those circles down. Leave them down. Oh, let me show you why. Let's see if I'm fair. Okay. Here we go. Oh crap, one second. Hold on, I gotta turn that down. Okay, so now you've got the entire thing covered. Oh, hold on a minute. All right, you got the whole thing covered with black, and you got your circles on there. Y'all are pretending, right? Because I don't have all my circles on here. Now, take Mr. Bowl, and you take Mr. Toothpaste, and you squirt it out in there, okay? Now, you're going to have to take a little bit of water. I'm not doing it because I'm not going to the bathroom, but y'all figure this out. You're going to take a little bit of water, and you just play around there, and you mix it around enough that it's kind of liquidy, kind of like paint, because toothpaste isn't really like paint. That's why they call it paste. They don't call it toothpaste. They call it paste. So you mix the water in there, and you get a little liquidy, and then you take your not your toothbrush. Somebody else's. Not really. An old one. Okay? Get a scrap piece of paper. Do you hear me? Get a scrap piece of paper. Get a scrap piece of paper. Get a scrap piece of paper. What are you going to get? Scrap piece of paper. And you're going to take that toothbrush. And you can also do this with a regular brush. But I'm just guessing maybe if y'all don't have a paintbrush. And you're just going to flick it. Yeah. Just like, I'm going to flick it out in the air. This is a shop. I don't care. Flick it. Flick it on that paper. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, you're going to send some big old gloves coming out at first. That's why y'all need to practice. Okay? And so you're going to stand back, and you're going to flick that paint all over your project. I didn't mean paint. I meant toothpaste. Now, if y'all have paint, that's perfect. Now, I did toothpaste, and then I was like, okay, what else? What else? I got mustard. So I rinsed this out, and I got some mustard, and I flicked the mustard on there. It was okay. It did dry a little bit more brown than I wanted it to, but again, it's mustard. So, anyway, after this is dry, and really you don't even have to wait till it's completely dry, you pull those circles off. And be very careful, especially if you use scotch tape, because it has a tendency to want to stick. And when you pull those circles off, ta-da! Underneath are these really cool, perfect little planets with your splatter on there. And you can see where I got a couple of places kind of globby right there. But that's okay because it looks kind of like a comet. Now, if you can imagine doing this with colored pencil, You can really get some cool shading in there, and you can actually make it look like a real planet. I mean, these are kind of like funky imaginary planets or whatever. And again, this is a basic stencil method that all your airbrushers use, all your, you know, Harley Guest, Tank Brothers use, everybody that, all your graffiti artists, everybody, they'd be using that stencil right there, and you'll be using that stencil today too, okay? And clean up your mess, and put your brother's toothbrush back so he don't know you've been using it, and I'll see y'all tomorrow.